we need to understand where is this money going. A lot of the money, a lot of the billions of dollars and billions of pounds went to the war on Iraq. Do you know how much money went to that? We're talking about billions of dollars, mate. Let me look it up. I want to look it up right now. How much money spent on Iraq? Money. I'm going to type it in. Money spent on Iraq. Let's look it up on the internet. Wow. 87billion.com. Yeah. $87 billion. Obviously, that wasn't just UK. That was America as well. If we spent $87 billion over the American football field, we would not be able to see much of the game. The players would be buried in 55 feet of money. So a lot of this money was spent on the war in Iraq, the war in Afghanistan. Why? You have to understand, why did they go to Iraq? Britain and America went to war in Iraq because the dollar, my friend, was going to lose its power. Yeah. Because Saddam was going to sell it into euros. That was the main reason for that. So, if Saddam sold it to in euros, then the American dollar would have lost its power, and they would have had to buy the oil in euros. And then, why is that a disadvantage for America? There wouldn't be the superpower today. Everything is run by oil. Everything. If there's no oil, you can't trade. Yeah? You can't trade, you can't transport yourselves. You cannot move. And you imagine how much oil they're pumping out through Iraq right now. Just try and imagine how much oil they're pumping out right now. Yeah? So this is the main reason for the war, yeah. This is the main reason for British troops and American troops to land in Iraq. And you think John Chirac, he cared about Iraqi people, and he caused no war, peace, and everything? That's all bullshit. The reason why John Chirac was opposing the war was because he didn't get his hands in that oil. If John Chirac had the chance to get his hands on that oil, he would also support the war. But just because he never had the chance to get that oil, that's why he was opposing them. That's why he opposed England, and that's why he opposed America. Because John Chirac, he could not get any of that oil. That is the main reason. Yeah. Do you really think French people really care about Muslims? They're banning the headscarves, for God's sakes. He can't even wear a headscarf in public. He can't even wear a headscarf in a school. They're banning them. So I don't really think he cares about Iraqi people, to be honest. But I'm not trying to be one-sided, yeah. I'm just trying to open your eyes a bit of what's going on around us right now. So why did BNP get to go on Question Time? So that he can give a wake-up call to the British people and to the rest of the world to say, look, this is our country. This country belongs to a Christian country, to Christian people. You ethnic people, black, Asian, brown, yellow, I don't know, yeah, that you can't take over us. We are in control of the situation. This is what BNP, what Nick Griffin, his main message is out to the people. That this belongs to a Christian country. Okay, let me say something about that. That is fine. I respect that. Okay, let me say something about that. As I'm a Muslim, I respect that. I respect Nick Griffin for saying that. That this is a Christian country. I actually would like to shake Nick Griffin's hand for pointing out this is a Christian country, because you know what? If this was a Christian country, it would be good. Yeah? But as it's not a Christian country, not anymore anyway, it's quite a shame, to be honest. Because you need to look at, rather than pinpointing at the Muslims, Nick Griffin needs to point out the Christian community. Yeah? needs to point out what's been going on the last 40 years, yeah, since World War II, what has been going on, yeah. But why is Christianity always getting attacked, yeah? Not just in England, in America as well. The reason for the decrease of Christianity is the fact that the government of UK and the governments of America and many of the European countries, they do not want to see the growth of Christianity. That's the main concern. That's the main thing which you got to look at. They do not want to see Christianity and Islam to increase because they've got plans for us. They want to control the world in their way of controlling it. And who controls everything at the moment? Zionists. They control everything we see, everything we listen to, everything basically. The bankers, they control, and who are the bankers? Mostly are Jewish bankers. They control everything. They don't want to see Christianity increase. So there's Nick Griffin on national television saying that I want this country to be given back to the Christians. I can understand. And I do actually understand where he's coming from. And I do respect him for saying that. But it's quite a shame, really, because the time we're living in, that they want to destroy religion. They want to destroy Christianity, and the same people also want to destroy Islam. So Christianity and Muslims have got the same enemy. And these enemies are Zionists. I'll be honest with you. These are the main enemy, and they control everything. Now, we need to understand that Nick Griffin is actually not the main person who's behind this. Who's leading this? Personally, I don't think it's Nick Griffin. Who's financing him? Who's supporting him? Who's behind the curtains? Do you even know the answer? It's the British government. That's the answer. British government is actually supporting Nick Griffin. They need people like Nick Griffin to wake up England, to wake up the rest of Europe as well, to say, look, we've got a problem here. We are facing a threat where we are getting taken over. By who is the question? Who is taking us over? The answer is Muslims. They're taking us over. This is the main reason. So this is a wake-up call, which the BNP want to give to the world. Firstly, to UK, to say, look, we've got a problem here. But we need to understand, why did someone like Nick Griffin get the chance to go on Question Time? How did he get that power to go on Question Time? And who allowed him to get on there? Who allowed him to get on Question Time was BBC. I need to understand, who controls BBC? Zionists. Zionists control BBC. They control the media. They control everything. So when BNP got on Question Time, somebody raised out a good point. They said that it's like, you know, Hitler is a bad person. Why do you want to put Hitler on national television when you know his views and what he stands for is wrong? So it's the same thing with Nick Griffin. Why do you want to give him the chance to go on national television when you know he stands for the wrong cause and he's going to create problems for the masses? So everybody knows that. But BBC still wanted Nick Griffin to come on Question Time. And you need to understand that how much publicity Nick Griffin got. How many millions of people saw Nick Griffin. And a lot of people were against Nick Griffin, but some people were also supporting Nick Griffin. And I'll tell you something, this is going to increase. A lot of people will start supporting Nick Griffin because we're facing a tough time of the year. And a lot of British people who had their jobs, they will start supporting him, and they want a lot of people out of this country. I think in the future this might happen, due to the fact that the government will support people like Nick Griffin in the future. So the government is actually responsible for everything, to be honest. See, this is the main thing you got to look at and try to understand. I rest my case. See you later, guys. I'll make another one soon. Bye. Peace out.